security victory.
Does it make it easier for you guys when you have guys like D'Lo and Bees combined and made 10 threes tonight?
Yeah, absolutely. We're not going to always shoot the ball well. Bron struggled tonight. I struggled tonight shooting the ball. But we have a complete team. Bees, shot the ball pretty well. D'Lo, Troy, Austin. So, the depth on our team is really strong. Where LeBron had 16, I have 14. We still able to get a very convincing win.
Always try to create a walkover.
Yeah, it wasn't the prettiest.
Just thinking of a
It's kind of like you in the first half. Sometimes you need the whole question to get there. It wasn't the prettiest of wins, but you were able to find something in the second half. Darvin basically said that the halftime message was just find something. Like push through this. Did the team show something to each other tonight?
Yeah, I mean, when you play teams that's not playing their guys, just like even Sunday, with Utah, those are tough teams to beat. Houston, young guys who, just play hard. These guys had an opportunity that they probably wouldn't have when their main guys are playing. They're always the toughest team to, to beat. They come in, make shots, play extremely hard, play aggressive. Play fast, and those are the toughest teams to beat. So, we just had to come in at halftime, regroup, made a run to end of half, and then come in halftime and just regroup and figure out a way to get a little separation. We came out third quarter, got some separation, and then they made a run, and then we made a run as well. And then late fourth quarter, just able to execute and get to what we wanted to, and guys made shots and made plays and got stopped. So, it's not going to always be pretty, just like in Utah, but still got to find a way to get the win.
You guys have won 8 of 10 overall. How would you assess kind of just the groove you guys have been in these last couple of weeks, getting Ron back and just kind of heading into the postseason?
Been a really good groove. I mean, obviously, it's a lot at stake, a lot on the line for us. So we have no choice but to find a rhythm and find a groove as a team. We've been able to do that and win some basketball games, without practicing and getting reps with each other. Our practice has been games. We've been able to figure it out on the fly, and our basketball IQ on this team is pretty high. So, even though practice has been limited, we've been able to communicate and talk about things that we want to do on the floor, and both things on the floor, and be able to execute at a high level. And the result has been in victories.
3 games in 4 days. How are you feeling physically?
Like I need tomorrow off. but right back at it early Sunday, and then see what happens as far as standings and where we are.
LeBron just said you and he were talking briefly before we all came in here. You guys are going to clinch at least the 500 record, and do you sense the grind? Is there some sense of accomplishment in that?
Yeah, I mean, the way we started, 0-5 and 1-5, 2-5 and 2-10 is just. Who would have thought, we'll finish the season above 500? We were joking with some of the other guys. They were like, yeah, and we was pointing to some guys like, man, we thank y'all. Because it looked like we was going that way to start the season. Yeah, man, we just kept pushing, kept grinding, and obviously the guys that was able to come in here to help us get some more wins and ultimately, finish above 500.
Last two.
Run here, trying to get wins every night, not being sure exactly where you're going to end up in a playoff or play-in situation. What's that been like for you?
Most of the guys, it's a lot to it, but for me, I just feel like we just need to win every single game, and we'll see what happens after that, and we'll handle business from there.
Clearly, the shots were going in for you tonight. Also, looked like that might have helped the defense even a little bit. Did you feel like that was kind of flowing together both ends of the court for you?
Yeah, definitely. They got a lot of great guys who shoot the ball, so I wanted to make sure, on the defensive end, I stayed attached to them, got out in transition a few times, and that helped a lot.
Malik, when you went through the spell when you were not making shots, how did you maintain your confidence, and what did you do to get back in rhythm?
Just kept working hard. Like I said, I put in a lot of work, so at some point it's going to fall, and tonight it did, and hopefully it continues through playoffs. That's what time I really wanted to come.
What does it feel like when it's going that good like it was tonight for you?
It feels good. The rim looks bigger. I can shoot the ball with more confidence and, you know, hopefully get the ball more because it's going in. So it felt good to get out and play a little bit more tonight and, you know, take advantage of the opportunity.
Dan?
I don't have it in front of me, but I think you guys have won something like 10 to 12, and you've done it with a change in the lineup, LeBron coming back, still plenty of rhythm and chemistry, things to work out. What's enabled you guys, you think, to win while trying to figure out how to grow as a team?
Our talent helps, but I think that we play hard. I think we got a lot of group of guys who play hard, and you know, we play together as a team. When the ball is stagnant, that's when it's tough for us. But when we're moving the ball, we're a hard team to beat. We got so many options and threats that it makes it easier for AD.
Darvin, what did you think kind of pulled you guys out of the whatever it was defensively or defensive glass in the first half, and eventually pulled away from Phoenix in the second?
I mean, I think guys just got their wind, got their legs up under them, you know. Technically, this is the backside of 3 and 4 nights. And so with the travel and getting in at weird hours, it's that time of the year, man. You know, I mean, you can't I know if I'm feeling tired and coaching staff, you know, I can only imagine how they feel. But we just got to figure out a way to power through. And that was the message at halftime, pretty much. We were able to put it together as the game wore on. We got a little bit stronger. Started seeing the ball go in more, started getting some stops, holding them to one possession. But, you know, it's that time of the year, man. Phoenix is a private ball club, even though with those guys being out, they still got, you know, that's why they're considered a championship caliber team, because of their roster and their depth. And they got a lot of guys over there that play hard nonstop. And so they're going to push you to the limit and make you earn that W. And I'm just happy we came out on the right side of it.
Technically, there's still so many different scenarios that could unfold. Of course, you can only control what you can on Sunday. But have you felt any of that, the team, just the uncertainty of who the opponent is going to be, what, on top of having to play the games with this whole playing concept?
No, I don't feel any lack of confidence. You know, it's just we have to do what we need to do to make sure we have the proper energy, the proper rest, the care, make sure we're taking care of our guys and their physical issues, and try to come out and put our best foot forward. That's the biggest thing, man. Like, everybody's dealing with a little something in terms of whether it's injuries or things that are hurting. And we just got to push through. Like, the film study is even more at a premium now. It's hard to get on the practice floor and do anything practice-wise. Mostly walkthroughs and try to, you know, make sure we get shots up, but talk through some coverages and some adjustments. But for the most part, I think rest is at the top of the list of things that needs to be done. And, you know, we'll figure it out. But we feel good, man. It was a good W to get. And we'll come out and do what we need to do tomorrow to put ourselves in a position to finish the regular season the right way on Sunday.
Darvin, how much do you think that D'Lo, Austin, and Malik helped to carry you guys through this tonight?
It's huge. If those guys be able to carry the load and make some shots and have their own different segments during the game, it's huge, man. And, you know, the more pressure we can take off Bron and AD to go out and save the day or make every play, the better. When they can just play manageable minutes, and those other guys step up and come out and play well, it just makes us that much more dangerous, and it also saves some gas for our two big dogs.
Darvin, the Warriors and Kings tipped off about a half hour before you guys, and that game obviously has implications on where things could end up playing-wise for you guys. Did you have any awareness of what was going on up?
Nah, I'm just trying to coach my team, man. Like, however it falls, whatever happens, we just got to be ready to do what we need to do. And if that's a secure spot at number 6, if that's, you know, 7 or 8 in the play-in, we just got to be ready to do what we need to do. And that's the way I've, you know, carry myself through life and in this sport. Like, take care of what you can take care of, control what you can.